Hey, buy more things. No!
I think that we decide to work against ads for all the good reasons. Advertising is not good for people's health, is not good for environment. It's promoting a capitalist way of life, a capitalist way of production.
It has some kind of a uniform speech. Whether a billboard is advertising about a political candidate, whether it's about junk food, or even if it's about an ethical product, it has all the same message, which is to consume.
We want to show that we do not agree with those messages and that we can fight against them.
We have a big issue with corporate influence. By controlling the finance of the media, thanks to advertising, big corporations control a lot of media and the digital world.
Entonces hemos creado una red de artistas y de activistas. Buscamos develar las diferentes formas en que la publicidad afecta a la sociedad.
In 2015, during the COP21, the international network called Brandalism came to Paris to organize a huge action. And in order to do that, they collaborated with French networks doing subvertising in the streets. And from this came up the idea of an international network that would help all the groups over the world that are fighting advertising to gather together. We called it Subvertisers International. It was kind of the beginning of the dynamic. We are now 6 years after that, and we can clearly say that the anti-advertising movement has grown up a lot. We have some groups that are interested in influencing the decision makers. We have some groups that practice civil disobedience and do action that are not legal, but really help the media to cover the issue. We have other groups that are more interested in one specific issue or the other. We use various strategies, we have a variety of policy visions, but we also all share that today advertising is taking a central role into consumerism that is bringing us into the climate crisis.
We're trying to make the question about ad in public space a political question. You can close the television or close the radio if you hear advertising and don't want to hear them. In public spaces, you don't have that choice. So the only choice you have is through action, through civil disobedience, reply to the publicity and advertising and change the content. We're not doing action ourselves, but as we promote techniques and tools for action, we also do training days. We want to give the tools to the citizen, to the people, to reply on their own, to see things that are more beautiful or that they would prefer to see.
Proyecto Squatters inició sus actividades en el año 2008 y desde entonces hemos creado tres líneas de acción. Una es el activismo en las calles, asaltar los carteles de publicidad para transformar y resignificar sus mensajes y contar de alguna manera aquello que las publicidades no cuentan. Y por otra parte, lo que hacemos es activismo digital, activismo en las redes, para dar a conocer el movimiento de la contrapublicidad. Y como tercera línea de acción, lo que hacemos es llevar talleres de contrapublicidad a las escuelas de una mirada crítica acerca de los medios de comunicación y de la publicidad.
When I first started intervening against advertising, I was painting over large billboards with a paint roller, dressed as a workman, just blanking them out completely. More recently, I've changed my approach to using fire extinguishers on large digital screens, and you know, then the police show up and inevitably charge me, handcuff me, even though I'm, you know, cooperative and really polite, I think. Even though advertising in its current form has been around for less than 100 years, people seem to think that it's beyond question, like it's just always going to be a part of our society. It really warrants a bold rejection just because the consequences of it are so dire.
The one doing civil disobedience are very helpful to throw the light on an issue and to generate debate, because civil disobedience is not a consensual way of action. It's easily covered by the media and it helps to put an issue on the table. We also want these people trying to influence decision makers, because thanks to them we have information on what's going on in the institutions and the communication sector and the lobby.
Our place in this network is really to do lobbying work, local, national, international, and we've been having quite some success on the lobby front.
So on average, we see 5,000 ads per day, and many of them are fossil ads.
We define that as the fossil fuel companies themselves, drilling for oil and gas, but also sellers of SUVs and of airlines.
Mostly it's about how green they are and how good they are for the world and how unmissable they are.
They take out the urgency of the climate problem, like, totally. Lets people believe that these companies are actually doing their best, while they are not, and also increases the demand for the products they are selling. Amsterdam was the first city in the world to actually ban fossil ads, so that's very cool. We try to create kind of like a snowball effect, like here's one wind popping up and here we have another municipality that wants to ban fossil ads. And from all this momentum creation, we try to have a national law and also inspire others around the world.
At the beginning, there were very few members. They were more like individuals that were trying to fight against advertising, like doing some actions in the subway, for example, in Paris. And in the time, during the 30 years, there have been more and more people engaging. We try to do sensibilization on people about how advertising is influencing their mind, their way of thinking and consuming.
We're dealing with deputies, with elected people. So we have to have some kind of image, kind of clean, so that we can talk with those people.
Vous avez des exemples à Lyon de publicité ou d'enseigne?
For breaking the law, we lose the credibility to write it and to be part of the process of writing it.
Discounts this year are deeper and more widespread. And also, there's a lot more advertising.
Globally, advertising does increase consumption. It not only brings in more consumers, but it also pushes the same consumers to consume more rapidly. That's what we call marketing obsolescence. And it's not only the planned obsolescence of a product that is going to be dysfunctional. It's really a product that's still functional, but people are going to throw away because a new product has come on the market. For example, in France, most young people are going to change their cell phone before the cell phone is actually dysfunctional. So marketing obsolescence is really a major issue, and advertising is at the core of it.
Advocacy is a network of groups in the UK who aim to eradicate all outdoor corporate advertising, and we celebrate arts, nature and community instead of ads. One of the things that we're working on and that we've been seeing for quite a while is a big proliferation of digital billboards. These screens have several things that are wrong with them. One of them is a lot of light pollution, and that blue light is powered by a lot of energy. One bigger billboard uses the same amount of energy as 11 average UK homes. As well as showing us more ads per minute, there's also the technology they're equipped with. That can include cameras, facial detection technology, which can target you according to your age or gender with different types of adverts. Once this technology has been installed, it's quite easy for it to be upgraded, and it's likely that we'll start to see the same targeted advertising that we used to in online marketing in our public space.
Thanks to the huge amount of data we've collected and combined, now for the first time, you are able to track and precisely reach your target audience when they are out of home and on the go at any time of the day, every day.
Our public spaces should be somewhere where we feel at home and we're able to escape and enjoy our communities, not where there's increased surveillance just to show us more targeted adverts.
So we address the issue of massive advertising and overconsumption, as well as the issue of advertising and greenwashing. We also address the fact that with purchase of space, advertisers control a lot of media and the internet. So it's a more democratic issue. So we really try to cover all the issues in order to clarify the transformation we are calling for.